Well, happy Testimony Tuesday. For me, it's still Happy Sanctified Sunday. I'd like to thank Sister Vicki for this opportunity. I was married to Sister Vicki's cousin for 30 years and 6 months, and they were like brother and sister. I like to say she was the voice of reason in his life. My children still refer to her as Aunt Vicki. I love you and appreciate you so much, Vicki. A little background on me. I was married to Vicki's cousin for 30 years, and for 15 of those years, he was very ill. He had 13 brain surgeries, and then the last 2 years of his life, he had been diagnosed with mesothelioma, a type of cancer, and the Lord took him home. I eventually married a pastor in Arkansas and moved up here to Arkansas. He subsequently became a bishop and then now serves on the Arkansas State Board. I have 4 children, all in ministry. 2 are pastors, 2 are lay ministers. I appreciate that so much, but that's the fruit. I know the seed. Now, I'd like to talk to you a little bit about that. Back when my husband was so ill during those 15 years, all 4 of my children backslid. He was sick. And that's when I really got a hold of the Word. I began to search the Word, and I would find promises that just stuck out to me. I am not a theologian. I am just a simple person. My name's Karen. It means simple. I like simplicity. My son-in-law, who I sit under, who's my pastor, we call him our resident theologian. He can tell you the Hebrew, Greek, Aramaic, all this kind of stuff. And that's wonderful. I love it. But I'm the simple one. And when the Word can speak to the theologian and the simple one at the same time, that's incredible to me. And that's what it did to me. I would get a hold of promises. I'll never leave you and I'll never forsake you. I realized I was not alone. I would write in my Bible, I wish I'd brought it with me, dates and names when he would give me the promises. And I looked through that Bible not too long ago, and it's full of dates, and it's full of names. See, everyone just looks at the fruit, but they don't understand there was a seed at one time. And that means so much to me when I look back and I saw that. And it was the coolest thing today when I looked on my Facebook memories. Believe it or not, God can use Facebook to speak to someone. And on my memories, it was a snapshot of a scripture. And it had the date, I think it was like August the 23rd, 1993. I knew the name. In the picture, I didn't have the name, but it was my pastor's wife. And she was going through the trial of her life. And the Lord had spoke to her. And he'd given her that scripture. And I knew I was going to record this today. And would you believe it came up on my memories today? I guess if you're not one that likes to write in your Bible, do it in a journal. Get in the Word. And when it speaks to you, when it just jumps out, make a little notation. On such and such date, February the 2nd, 2020, this spoke to me for this situation. Because 10, 20, and 30 years later, you can look back and you can say, God did that for me. It wasn't the preacher or the preacher in my family or the bishop or the presbyter or whomever. It was me that he spoke to. It can be you that he spoke to. I love the Word. I love what the Word can do. I love the power of the Word. I'm at the age now, I can't even remember what mountain who all was on, and I get it all mixed up. I can't remember the chapter and the verse, but I can tell you if it's there, and I can tell you when it speaks to me. You don't have to be the most educated person in the world. You don't have to be the theologian for the Word to speak to you. I love the simplicity of the gospel. I guess that's my short testimony. If I didn't thank my daughter for doing this for me, I'm actually at her house, and she has three kids. She just bathed and stuck in another room where we could come and record this real quick because we've all been busy all day long. But there again, I'm thankful for this site. Vicki, I love you so much. God bless you all.